Hey everyone, today I'm going to keep with this month's theme of shop organization, and I'm going to show you how I made my clamp rack. Before I had my clamp rack, I used to store all my clamps on the garage door. When I would need to open my garage door, I would have to relocate my clamps, usually to my fold-up trailer. Now, when I would need to use my trailer, well, my clamps would just end up everywhere. So let's get started. I started off by laying out and cutting the tops of the rack that the clamps would be sitting in. I'm using 3/4 inch plywood, and I cut these pieces 4 inches wide by 14 inches long. But depending on the clamps that you have, all these measurements may be different. Now I'm just sticking two of these tops together with double-sided tape. Then I take it to the drill press and drill holes for the slots with a 5/16 inch bit. And then cut the slots with the bandsaw. The slots I cut out here are 5/16 inch wide and 1 inch space inside to inside measurement. I made 6 tops and now ready to move on to the back. I cut the back 3 3/4 inches wide and 14 inches long. I then took my pieces to the router table and made a rabbet 3/8 inches deep by 3/4 inches wide. As I clamp these 2 pieces together, I try not to make my clamps too tight, as it may cause the pieces to actually become out of square from the pressure. For the sides, I cut pieces to fit. Mark the insides of the rack and draw a line between the two. Hopefully that makes sense. Just take it to the sander to clean it up, glue it, and then I pin nail it just to keep it in place while the glue dries. Next, I'm going to cut out some gussets. I'm just using scrap wood for these and cut it out on the bandsaw. Now, I made gussets for every finger, which probably is overkill, but I kind of like the look of it, and I was using scrap wood anyways. So then I just glue all the gussets in place. So here you see I've made 6 clamp racks, and at this point you can hang these up and use these as 6 individual clamp racks. I'm not going to do that. I'm actually going to take this a little further and do something a little different. Here I'm going to go ahead and cut up some sides for these. I cut the width to fit the tops at 4 9/16, and then I cut 2 pieces at 30 inches, 2 pieces at 20 inches, and 2 pieces at 10 inches long. For now I'm just using some particle board that's laminated that I tore off a cheap coffee table. Just clamp the sides to 2 of the tops that are facing each other, then I'll go and drill pilot holes, sink them, and then screw them to the tops. Here's what I end up with. Here's all 3 of them, 3 different sizes, and I made them different sizes to fit the different size clamps. Then I'm just going to throw some hinges on it so that it'll take up a smaller footprint when I hang it up on the wall. here it is, hanging up on the wall. Now you can hang it up using different methods. You can use French cleat. I just screwed 4 screws through the backs of the racks, straight into some 2x4s that go in between the studs. Then I sanded everything, painted it, and I put some trimming on the front ends, the red parts you see there. And like everything else in my shop, I painted it black and red. Hope you liked the video and the build. If you did, please like, subscribe, thumbs up, and all that good stuff. And until next time, be safe.